The following is an exclusive presentation of Winnipeg's Best Rock, Power 97.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another Studio 97 performance with Finger 11!
Beautiful. I was thinking of doing some introductions, but I think everybody here knows you, so let's just get right into a tune. You ready, Scott?
Yeah, absolutely.
Beautiful.
Laughing lovers can overcome their closest demons, and they'll go on, and they won't let go. No. Oh no, they saw something that they know. Stay until we know ourselves. I'm torn as I tell. You're the story that I know when fell from. I'm so far into your story. I don't know why we gotta show real soon, or we'll never reach this high. We climb a little further, 'cause there's nothing we can get around together. Further gets colder, until nothing was all that I saw around. So we stay until the ground that we can't come down from splits us away. Maybe stars know why we fall. I just wish they were thinking. Oh, I could wish
Power 97, Studio 97 with Finger 11. A lot of numbers there. Quickly, let's do some introductions. Let's just go around the horn here. We'll start with you, Scott.
I'm Scott. Right. How about that?
Vocals.
I'm the singer guy.
Okay.
Hi, I'm James. The guy who messed that one up.
James on guitar.
James on guitar.
Hi, my name's Sean. I'm on bass.
Hi, my name's Sean. I'm on bass.
I'm Rick.
And I'm Sean on bass.
And we got Rich behind the kit there. Well, first off, thanks for doing this.
Oh, you're welcome. So far, so good.
Cool, man. Yeah.
You guys in the middle of a tour right now with Ozzy Osbourne. How's that going?
Great, surreal, fantastic. Nothing really negative so far, you know?
Cool.
It's been awesome.
You hanging out with Ozzy?
I'd love to tell you, yeah. You know, he doesn't really hang out too much, but we've seen him kind of like being escorted around. Seen like every other rock legend on the tour, but you know, Ozzy's pretty well protected.
Newstead.
I saw him kind of running aimlessly through the arena in Calgary. Oh, no, sorry, Edmonton.
He got lost?
He looked lost.
Well, yeah, it's. So he looked Ozzy.
Yeah, exactly.
Beautiful. Do you guys still play Thin Spirits from the first one?
We do. I hope you didn't want to hear it today, though.
No.
We haven't been rehearsing.
I'm hearing the explanation for the name of the band is in that song, so
yeah.
That's why I brought it up.
Well, it's funny, because as soon as that was an original lyric in a song called Thin Spirits, which is the first record, and I took it out. As soon as I wrote that lyric and we considered that idea for the band, I was like, I don't want any kind of anthem thing.
Yeah.
I'm going to take it out. You know. But as soon as I sang it, we were trying to like put stuff together in the studio. We were trying to like write this Thin Spirits song, and we just needed a name. And everybody really reacted to this Finger 11 idea, pointing the other way, kind of making your own choices, being, you know, just getting closer to becoming a complete individual. You know, that was what it was all about. You make these choices based on your own instinct. And they're like, man, that's cool. That's really cool. And so we just kept it.
Cool. Excellent. Well, you know, for some of us that may not have known about the band name, that's
right.
It's good.
That's
we're caught up. let's talk about the new record. Enough about the first one. I haven't had a chance to hear it. What can you tell us about the new record?
Are you missing out, man?
It's awesome.
You haven't heard it, man? It's so good.
It's maybe closer to a more fully realized record as far as the band is concerned. You know, this highly collaborative effort, you know, between the band, and we took a long, long time to write all these songs, and that kind of cut down the time it took to record. And really, it was kind of about making, you know, music we thought was really solid in a really straight, unpretentious, rockin' sort of way.
You guys are going to throw a DVD in there, I've read,
yeah.
Or that's been hinted at?
Yeah, there's some neat stuff going on. There's like a documentary that Rich shot of us in the studio, and we look really hard working. It's awesome. It's wicked the way you put it together. We look like we're all pro.
Nice.
And there's like a live show in there from Buffalo, which is fine, which is what it is. It's free, so, you know, it can't really be too harsh. But and then there's the new video for Good Times, which is the first, you know,
right.
Single.
And the 17th is what we're looking at now, right? Because we've had some different dates tossed around here, but 17th is firm now for the release of the self-title?
Yeah.
Okay, good. Official. Good to hear. Why did it take so long to make this record? Or have you already answered that question for us?
No, pretty much we just had the luxury of time. We had the luxury of not having a big smash record, you know? We didn't have any pressure from anybody. So they're like, just take as long as you want, dude. It's fine. So, you know, we took about a year and a half, and... you know, that's not all bands kind of have that luxury. So, you know, we just did it from Monday to Friday after we toured Grace Blue Skies. We just very quickly got into writing mode, maybe took 1 or 2 weeks off, and then just treated it like a job. And, I mean, there's nothing like the objectivity that time can provide, you know, because, you work on one idea, and the newest idea is always the coolest. You know, this is awesome. It's a brand new idea.
So I was going to say, it's sort of like it was hard to stop because every time we decide, okay, like this is the date we're stopping, like the day before we'd write one of the better songs we'd written to that point, we'd be like, okay, well, we got to keep going because the good stuff is still coming. So
nice.
It was pretty much that.
Is this the first time you've had a chance to try these songs out, these new songs out live with this Ozzy tour? And how's that going, you guys?
Well, actually, no, we did some of the songs on the last time through with OLP. But
yeah, there was a few shows. We did a show in Victoria that was our own show. We're trying out a lot of like the stuff today. We've only ever played this stuff like
once.
This is the second time, I think.
Yeah.
Here, so
it's good because the stuff has been done since January. So it's nice to not have to sit on it any longer, you know, get a nice reaction out of this. This is cool.
Yeah, the Johnny Kay from Disturbed.
Yeah.
You worked with him. How was that? What was that like?
Excellent. We weren't really sure who we were meeting, you know, when we agreed to meet with him. But we're like, well, you know, what's a dinner? Let's go meet this Johnny Kay guy. And we had sent him demos, and it's always interesting to see how deep a producer can, you know, how much he was listening, and he was listening very, very closely. It became pretty apparent through the dinner. You know, he was citing specific ideas in the songs and lyrics, and just like he really, really got the band where we wanted to go. He wasn't ready to, like, you know, yeah, this is nice, but let's skew over here. You know, he was really kind of there and dedicated to what the band wanted to get out of the record. So we did this trial period in L.A. where we wrote, where we recorded a song called Sad Exchange and Good Times. And that was kind of little microscopic idea of what it might be like to make a full record with them. And it went so well, that's exactly what we did.
Cool. The first song you played, Thousand Mile Wish, that'll be on the new record?
Yes, it will.
Excellent. Okay. Is this next tune you're going to play, is this going to be on the record?
If the next song is called Unspoken, then no, okay. It won't be on the record.
All right.
Yeah, you speaks in riddles.
This
could be the only time you ever hear this song.
Yeah, nice. We have no plans to release this or anything. We wrote it. We thought it was really cool, but trying to shape the record, we kind of axed it.
Okay, cool. Do you want a player for us?
Are we going to go now? Okay,
yeah,
sure.
Let's do it. This is Power 97, Finger 11, Studio 97.
I don't wanna be alone. I'd rather
Thank you. Thank you.
That sounds amazing, guys. Thank you. 11, Studio 97, Power 97. We got any street team members in here? Yeah, we do. We got
a couple.
Finger 11 one. Street teamers. We got a question from the audience. What's your name, man?
Chris Vermette. I'm on a member on your message board, and there was some rumors earlier on in the process of the album about maybe a double album coming out because you guys had so much content for it. Was there truth to that rumor from you guys, or was that just kind of something that aroused on the internet?
That might be some drunken rant. something we'd like to do in a crazy, ambitious dream.
Well, you're going to have to throw Unspoken on there.
Thank you very much. I think there's only truth to the fact that we had enough material to kind of, you know, we what was the grand total after a year and a half of making stuff? What was it? Like, as far as like full musical ideas?
Maybe 30 songs.
Maybe around 30. So, you know, potentially there was that, but it was always nice to have the luxury of, you know, distilling those things and making a record.
Yeah.
You know?
But yeah, I think the only time a double record works is if it's necessary for the second half, you know what I mean?
Like, right.
As far as storytelling or something.
I have a question about the translation of your songs to an acoustic level like you're doing right now. Why do you think it works so well?
Right currently now?
Yeah. I've talked to lots of people about, before we were doing this, about bringing you guys in and doing you acoustically, and they were, you got to do it. It's amazing. Cool. You did something with MTV Canada not too long ago, or last year or something?
We might have. I don't remember.
We are that busy.
No. We're just that forgetful. You know, thank you very much. I don't know,
Bob. I gotta tell you, we do so many. Your name's Bob, right? We do so many of these interviews. It's just hard to keep track.
I'm not trying to be cool by way of forgetting stuff. I'm just saying I don't remember. But that's kind of great. I mean, it's fun to do acoustic things because it's quite different from what we usually do. You know, in a concert setting. I don't know why.
I think when we're writing the songs, we try and keep like that kind of mentality in mind. Like, we actually, Arnold taught when we worked with him, he had that sort of philosophy, like a good song should be able to be played on acoustic guitar or piano. It doesn't necessarily have to have all the wild guitars and all loud drum parts. So maybe we're achieving what we tried to do. Like, I don't know, we just enjoy doing it though. We sort of like to play all types. Like, we play soft naturally. Like, we'll do that half the time. We're not always rocking out. So.
Well, it sounds really good. We got one more tune to go here. A couple more questions as well. You guys hockey fans?
Rick is.
I'm a hockey
Sean
fan.
Sean is.
Yeah.
And then we'll
Ducks,
watch,
Devils?
You know.
Ducks.
Really?
Yeah.
Dude, you got the right answer, man. All right.
The Ducks, for sure.
Cool.
Yeah.
Game 7 tomorrow. Should be exciting.
It'll
Ducks
be awesome.
Made a series out of it.
Yeah, it's going to be incredible. Game 7 of Stanley Cup doesn't get much better than that.
On the sports theme, I was reading that you guys played a lot of foosball.
We sure did.
When you guys were recording the record.
We did.
Definitely.
Who's the king of the foosball table here?
It depends on what aspect of the game you're talking about. That's how.
Yeah.
Truly. James and I are in defense. Rick is like full on offense. Sean is wincingly slow and methodical, but will always score.
Very, very effective. Very.
And then Rich just throws caution to the wind. Man. Has the speed of Rick, but has the unpredictableness of Rich Beto. So,
well, that's a good breakdown.
Have you thought of that before, Scott? Like, that would just came.
Not that I've been thinking about it for a while. You know, how do I beat them? How do I overcome? No.
You guys play a lot of video games too. What's the favorite?
I miss Battlefield 1942 very much. I have a big, stupid computer at home, and that's what I used to do. It's, for those of you that aren't nerds, it's a comic book World War II game. It's really good.
Cool. All right. And I got a question I'm not sure you're going to be able to answer because I don't know the politics of it, but I was in Los Angeles last year, and I was in the Village where you guys did some recording, and I sort of was wandering around, and the guy that runs the place saw me and said, hey, do you want to see some stuff? So he walked me through the upstairs and all that. I saw Buckethead's chicken coop.
Yeah, we saw that too.
And saw where GNR's hanging out. Did you guys get a chance, I don't know, to hear any of the new GNR?
We heard him
shredding through the wall, man.
Like the tail end of a song. It was like, sort of like a November Rain kind of deal, like big epic climb. And he was just shredding over time.
It didn't even sound human. It was like...
I did hear some of the new Olivia Newton-John as well. So yeah. What do you think of that? That's pretty cool.
That's fantastic. This next tune you guys are going to do, what do you want to tell us about this one? It's going to be on the new record as well.
Yep.
One thing.
Yeah, this was just a song that kind of, I don't really know. The circumstances were just Jay and I were up at a cottage and we had an acoustic guitar. And, you know, this is kind of what happened. I'm glad it happened, but I just don't know why it did.
Beautiful. Let's do it. Finger 11, Studio 97. Power 97.
Restless tonight, 'cause I wasted the light. Between both these times, I drew a really thin line. It's nothing I planned, and not that I can. But you should be mine, across that line. If I traded it home, if I gave it all away for one thing, and just for one thing. If I sorted it out, if I knew all about this one thing, wouldn't that be something? I promise I might not walk on by. Maybe next time, but not this time. Even though I know, I don't wanna know. Yeah, I guess I know, I just hate how it sounds. If I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, just for one thing. If I sorted it out, if I knew all about this one thing, wouldn't that be something? If I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, and just for one thing. If I sorted it out, if I knew all about this one thing, wouldn't that be something? Even though I know, I don't wanna know. Yeah, I guess I know, I just hate how it sounds. Even though I know, I don't wanna know. Yeah, I guess I know. I just hate how it sounds. If I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, just for one thing. If I sorted it out, if I knew. If I gave it all away for one thing,
That was fantastic.
Cool, thank you.
Listen, thanks guys for coming down.
Thank you so much.
One thing, that's got to be a hit. That's got to be a single. If I don't get that soon from Sony, I'm going to be kicking some butt.
Thank you very much.
No, that's you guys, thanks for coming down. We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
You guys
thank
have
you.
Good show tonight.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thanks a lot.
What time are you going to be on stage? Any idea?
Yeah, 8:15 exactly.
Okay, cool.
Ozzy is going to kick our ass.
All right, 8:15. And the album, a self-titled release from Finger 11, will be in stores on June 17th. Don't miss them at Ozzy tonight. Let's go with Good Times there, Hoopé. Once again, thanks for coming down, guys.
Thank you.
One more time for Finger 11, Studio 97, Winnipeg's Best Rock Power 97.